Definition of units. Let capital R be a commutative ring with unity element. An element A belongs to R is a unit in capital R if there exists an element B belongs to R such that A into B is equals to 1. In other words, units of capital R are those elements of capital R which possesses multiplicative inverse. Note, unit is different from unity element in a ring. Unity element is the multiplicative identity element. There may be more than one units in a ring, but the unity element is always unique in a ring. Unity is also one of the units. The second point, in the ring of integers z, plus, dot, the unity element is 1, but units are 1 and minus 1 because the only elements in ring of integers have multiplicative identity are 1 and minus 1. That is, 1 into 1 is equal to 1, minus 1 into minus 1 is equal to 1. Therefore, 1 and minus 1 are the only two elements in Z which have multiplicative inverse. Therefore, 1 and minus 1 are units, and remember that 1 is the unit element. Every non-zero element of a field possesses multiplicative inverse, and hence every non-zero element of a field is a unit. If A is a unit of a ring capital R, then its inverse A inverse is also a unit in capital R. Also, the product of two units is again a unit because AB inverse is equals to B inverse and A inverse belongs to R. A problem: find all the units of the integral domain of Gaussian integers. Solution: let J of I is equals to the set containing elements of the form A plus I into B such that A and B are integers. B, the ring of Gaussian integers. The element 1 plus I into 0, namely 1, is the unity element of this ring. Let X plus IY be a unit and X1 plus I into Y1 be its inverse. We know that units of a commutative ring with unity are the elements of the ring which possesses multiplicative inverse. Therefore, now we have to write X plus IY into X1 plus I into Y1 is equals to 1 plus 0 into I, where this 1 is the unit element of J of I. Now our aim is to find the values of X and Y, because we have assumed that X plus IY be a unit. Therefore, we have to find the value of X plus IY. This implies, if you multiply these two complex numbers, we have a X into X1 plus I into XY1 plus IYX1 plus I into I squared Y into Y1 is equals to 1 plus 0 I. This implies XX1 minus, we know that I squared value is minus 1. Therefore, we can write this as x x1 minus y y1 plus I into x y1 plus y x1 is equals to 1 plus I into 0. That is, we have written real part separately and imaginary part separately. Left hand side is a complex number. Right hand side is also a complex number. We have an equal sign between them. Therefore, these two complex numbers are equal. We know that two complex numbers are equal provided their real parts are equal and imaginary parts are equal. Therefore, equating real and imaginary parts, we get x x1 minus y y1 is equals to 1. And the imaginary parts x y1 plus y x1 is equals to 0. Let us call this as 1 and this equation is 2. Now, 1 squared plus 2 squared gives x x1 minus y y1 whole squared plus x y1 plus y x1 whole squared is equals to 1. Using a minus b whole squared formula, we are going to expand this. Here we are going to use a plus b whole squared formula. Therefore, this becomes x squared x1 whole squared plus y squared y1 whole squared minus 2xx1 yy1 plus, here a plus b whole squared form. Therefore, x squared y1 squared plus y squared x1 squared plus 2 times x x1 y y1 is equals to 0. If you see here, we have minus 2xx1 yy1 here plus 2xx1 yy1. Therefore, these two terms get cancelled. Therefore, we get x squared x1 whole squared plus y squared y1 whole squared plus x squared y1 squared plus y squared x1 whole squared is equals to 1. Let us take x squared common from these two terms, and hence we get x1 whole squared plus y1 whole squared. From the second term and the fourth term, we can take y squared is common. Therefore, y squared into y1 squared plus x1 whole squared is equals to 1. Now, if you consider this, here x1 squared plus y1 squared is a common factor. Therefore, take it out. When you take out this, we will get x squared plus y squared into x1 squared plus y1 squared is equals to 1. Now, our aim is to find the values of x and y. We know that the product of two positive integers can be equal to 1 if and only if each of them is 1. This x squared plus y squared is a positive integer. X1 squared plus y1 squared is also a positive integer. Because x, x1, y, y1 are integers. But since we have a square, x squared, y squared, x1 squared, y1 squared. Therefore, the square of any integer must be a positive integer. Therefore, here the factor x squared plus y squared is a positive integer. The another factor x1 squared plus y1 squared is also a positive integer. And the product is equal to 1. This is true if and only if x squared plus y squared equal to 1 and x1 squared plus y1 squared is equals to 1. This is the one, x1 squared plus y1 squared equal to 1 and y1 squared plus x1 squared equal to 1. But we are interested on x and y. Therefore, x squared plus y squared equal to 1. Since x and y are integers, if x squared is 0, y squared is 1. Or if x squared is equal to 1, y squared must be 0. Thus, x squared is equal to 0 means 0. Y squared equal to 1 implies y equal to plus or minus 1. Or x squared equal to 1 implies x is equal to plus or minus 1. Y squared equal to 0 implies y equal to 0. Therefore, the only units of the integral domain of Gaussian integers are x plus I y is equals to 0 plus or minus I into 1, or x plus I y is equals to plus or minus 1 plus I into 0. We have substituted the values of x and y here. 0 plus or minus I into 1 is nothing but plus or minus I. Plus or minus 1 plus I into 0 is nothing but plus or minus 1. Therefore, we have only 4 values. They are all plus I minus I plus 1 minus 1. Therefore, this implies 1 minus 1, I minus I are the only values of x plus I into y. Therefore, the Gaussian integers are 1 minus 1, I minus I. Food for thought. In 1832, Gauss very carefully showed that the system of complex numbers with the form a plus ib, where a and b are ordinary integers, the so-called Gaussian integers, does possess the property of unique factorization into primes. Associates. The definition of associates says that let R be a commutative ring with unity element 1, then an element small a of R is said to be an associate of small b belongs to R if small a is equals to u into b for some unit u in R. In symbol, A is an associate of B, is written as A delta B. Note, in a commutative ring with unity element 1, all the associates of an element can be obtained by multiplying that element by the units of the ring. The only units of integral domain of integers are 1 and minus 1. So, if A is any non-zero integer, then it has exactly two associates, namely 1 into A and minus 1 into A. For example, the associates of 7 are 1 into 7 and minus 1 into 7, that is 7 and minus 7. In any commutative ring with unity, associates of 0 is 0. Find all the associates of non-zero element x plus iy of the integral domain of Gaussian integers. Solution: we know that units in the integral domain of Gaussian integers are 1 minus 1, I minus I. Therefore, associates of x plus iy are x plus iy into 1, comma x plus iy into minus 1, comma x plus iy into I, comma x plus iy into minus I. That is, x plus iy into 1 is x plus iy. X plus iy into minus 1 becomes minus x minus iy. X plus iy into I becomes xi minus y, because I and I is I squared, whose value is minus 1. X plus iy into minus I becomes minus xi plus y. Therefore, x plus iy, comma minus x minus iy, comma xi minus y, comma minus xi plus y are the associates of non-zero element x plus iy of the integral domain of Gaussian integers. Find all the associates of Gaussian integers 2 plus I. We know that units of integral domain of Gaussian integers are 1 minus 1 I minus I. Therefore, associates of 2 plus I are 2 plus I into 1, comma 2 plus I into minus 1, comma 2 plus I into I, comma 2 plus I into minus I. That is, 2 plus I into 1 is 2 plus I. 2 plus I into minus 1 is minus 2 minus I. 2 plus I into I becomes 2I minus 1 because I into I is I squared whose value is minus 1. 2 plus I into minus I is minus 2I plus 1. Therefore, 2 plus I comma 2 minus I comma 2I minus 1 comma minus 2I plus 1 are the associates of Gaussian integers 2 plus I.